नमस्कार, मैं हूं निवेदिता। कश्मीर का मुद्दा इस वक्त सिर्फ और सिर्फ पाकिस्तानी लोगों के बीच उछला हुआ है और इसे पाक पीएम इमरान खान और उनके मंत्रिमंडल के लोग ही ट्विटर पर उछाले हुए हैं और इसका कोई फायदा दुनिया के सामने नहीं दिख रहा है और ना ही कश्मीर मुद्दे को लोग तवज्जो दे रहे हैं। पिछले 3 दिन से अमेरिका में कई राउंड की मीटिंग करने के बाद पाक प्रधानमंत्री इमरान खान कश्मीर मुद्दे पर मोदी के सामने हथियार डाल चुके हैं और कह चुके हैं कि दुनिया कश्मीर के मुद्दे को सीरियसली नहीं ले रही है। यहाँ पर कुछ पुरानी बातें आपको बताते चलें, फिर हम इमरान खान के मुद्दे पर आते हैं। सबसे पहले कश्मीर मुद्दे को लेकर पाक सरकार ने संसद में बैठक बुलाई थी, जहां पर इमरान खान के धुर विरोधी पीपल्स पार्टी के नेता और पूर्व विदेश मंत्री हिना रब्बानी खार ने संसद में इमरान पर हमला करते हुए कहा था कि इमरान खान, आप कश्मीर पर हार स्वीकार कर लें, नहीं मोदी आपको कहीं का नहीं छोड़ेगा। ये तो रही पुरानी बात। अभी हाल ही में पाक प्रधानमंत्री इमरान खान संयुक्त राष्ट्र संघ के लिए अमेरिका रवाना होने से पहले सऊदी अरब के दौरे पर गए, जहां उन्होंने सऊदी राजकुमार सलमान से बात की और कश्मीर को लेकर समर्थन मांगा। इस पर सऊदी राजकुमार ने टका सा जवाब देते हुए कहा कि कश्मीर भारत का अंदरूनी मामला है और कश्मीर पर राग अलापना बंद करो, हम संयुक्त राष्ट्र संघ में तुम्हारा समर्थन नहीं करेंगे। इसके बाद इमरान खान मुंह लटकाए रियाद से न्यूयॉर्क के लिए रवाना हुए और अब न्यूयॉर्क में दुनिया के देशों के साथ इमरान खान बातचीत करके अपनी औकात जान चुके हैं और इसलिए अब उनका बयान आया है कि कश्मीर को लेकर दुनिया पाकिस्तान का समर्थन करने से इनकार कर रही है। पाक प्रधानमंत्री इमरान ने कहा कि मैं अंतर्राष्ट्रीय समुदाय से निराश हूं, यदि 8 मिलियन यूरोपीय और यहूदी, यहां तक कि 8 अमेरिकियों को घेराबंदी में रखा गया होता तो क्या तब भी यही प्रतिक्रिया होती, लेकिन हम दबाव डालते रहेंगे। इमरान खान ने आगे कहा कि कश्मीर से एक बार कर्फ्यू हटता है तो अल्लाह जानता है कि उसके बाद क्या होगा। आपको लगता है कि कश्मीरी चुपचाप स्वीकार कर लेंगे? इमरान खान जब ये सब बातें बोल रहे थे उस वक्त उनके साथ विदेश मंत्री शाह महमूद कुरैशी भी मौजूद थे, तो आप समझ सकते हैं कि विश्व बिरादरी के सामने पाक की क्या हैसियत है। यहाँ पर एक बात बता दें कि पाकिस्तान अंतर्राष्ट्रीय मंच पर कश्मीर को लेकर कई बार पहले ही हार चुका है। कश्मीर से धारा 370 हटाए जाने के बाद से इमरान खान बौखलाहट में हैं और भारत के खिलाफ दुनिया के देशों को भड़काने की पूरी कोशिश कर रहे हैं, लेकिन उन्हें हार ही मिली है और इसी वजह से पाकिस्तानी प्रधानमंत्री इमरान खान निराश होते जा रहे हैं। वहीं कश्मीर पर पाकिस्तान को महासभा से पहले पटकनी देने के बाद भारत की बाछें खिली हुई हैं और अब भारत पाकिस्तान को अंतिम पटकनी महासभा में देने के लिए तैयारी कर रहा है। देखना दिलचस्प होगा कि 27 तारीख को भारत कैसे पाकिस्तान को पटकनी देता है।
फ्रेंड्स, गुड आफ्टरनून, नमस्कार एंड वेलकम टू द स्पेशल ब्रीफिंग फ्रॉम न्यूयॉर्क ऑन प्राइम मिनिस्टर्स विजिट फॉर द यूएनजीए। We just concluded a bilateral meeting, Prime Minister and President Trump, and I have with me the Foreign Secretary of India, Shri Vijay Gokhale, who will brief you on the bilateral meeting between the two leaders. Sir, over to you.
Friends, Prime Minister met President Trump a short while ago at the UN organization headquarters in New York. This is the fourth engagement that the two leaders have had in as many months after the meetings in Osaka, in Biarritz, and of course, President Trump's participation at the event in Houston on Sunday. Essentially, we are therefore building on the conversations that the two leaders have already had over the last few meetings. And the objective of this bilateral meeting was to see how we could progress the relationship and deepen it further. As you know, the two leaders share an excellent rapport. Those of you who were present at the press spray before the meeting heard the President say that relations have never been better, and the Prime Minister and the President also enjoy a good relationship, and that relationship translates into a broader understanding between the two countries. After the press withdrew, the two leaders began with a discussion on trade issues. These are issues which both sides consider important. As you know, we have made significant progress in terms of both growing the trade between the two countries in the last three or four years, and in terms of reducing the trade deficit as well. In fact, perhaps among the top 10 trading countries, India is the only one where trade has both grown with the United States and the trade deficit has also reduced. Now, both leaders reviewed the discussions that are ongoing. The Commerce and Industry Minister, Mr. Piyush Goyal, has specially travelled to New York over the weekend He has been having discussions with U.S. Trade Representative Lighthizer. Significant progress has been made on a number of issues. We have narrowed the areas of difference. The two leaders therefore felt that they were optimistic in terms of us reaching some kind of a trade agreement in the near future. And discussions will continue in this regard. The Prime Minister did repeatedly say that India has taken a number of steps, including most recently during his visit to Houston, where Indian companies are also investing in the United States. And therefore, it is a symbiotic relationship, one that involves give and take. After that, the other topic that came up was a long discussion on terrorism. Prime Minister explained in some detail the challenges that we have faced on terrorism, and particularly terrorism in Jammu and Kashmir over the last 30 years. Prime Minister underscored to President Trump that 42,000 lives have been lost to terror attacks in the last 30 years, and that it is incumbent on the international community to join together to fight this scourge of terrorism. Prime Minister also mentioned to President Trump that that globally, from a number of developed countries as well, there have been significant numbers of fighters who have, or what they call foreign fighters, which have participated in terrorist activities globally. And he pointed to the fact that although we have the largest or probably the second largest population of citizens of the Muslim faith in India, there has been a significantly lower level of participation and a lower level of radicalization in India than there has been in almost any other part of the world. And this is an important fact that ought to be recognized by the international community, and President Trump acknowledged and took note of this fact. Prime Minister also explained that we have never shied away from talking to Pakistan. However, we expect that overtures that Prime Minister has made over the years ought to have been reciprocated, and none of them have been reciprocated, beginning with Prime Minister's invitation at the oath-taking ceremony, and then, as Prime Minister said, his unique and trip to Lahore in December 2015 with minimum security. And Prime Minister explained to President Trump that immediately after that, there has been an attack on the Pathankot airbase, and that the perpetrators of the crime have not been called to justice. So there was a discussion on the impact that terrorism has on communities, has globally, and Prime Minister and President Trump felt that we must both come together to fight terrorism. So essentially, these were the two broad topics discussed. It was a brief meeting because time is constrained on all sides. So the UN is a forum where all world leaders are meeting other world leaders, and the Prime Minister and President Trump had to attend the Secretary General's lunch immediately after. So it was a meeting of about, half an hour or 40 minutes. And we believe that we are quite satisfied with the outcome of this meeting. We are optimistic that on the trade front, we will see significant progress soon. We believe that we have given a good understanding to the US side about the challenges that we face on account of terrorism in India, including in Jammu and Kashmir. And the meeting ended with the Prime Minister's reminder to President Trump that we would be looking forward to welcoming him in India whenever he and his family decide to come. So that was the gist of the meeting. Before I take questions, I also thought I would mention that after the lunch by the UN Secretary General, the first of the two plurilaterals will be taking place. That is the meeting between the Prime Minister of India and the heads of state and government of the Pacific Small Island states, which for us is important because these have been countries which are vulnerable, with which we have been doing a lot in terms of development assistance, and which now play a critical role in our Indo-Pacific outlook or Indo-Pacific vision. Following that, of course, the Prime Minister will be holding the event to commemorate the 150th anniversary of Gandhiji at the UN in the presence of a number of world leaders, including the President of South Korea, the Prime Ministers of Singapore, Bangladesh, New Zealand, and Jamaica, and the Secretary General himself. He will, by remote inauguration, open the Gandhi Garden at the New York University or the State University of New York and the stamp. And then he will end the day with the accepting the award being given by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. So that's the rest of the program for today.
Thank you very much, sir. We have time for a few questions.
Shriram Lakshman from the Hindu. What specifically derailed the trade deal for now? Was it ICT products? That's what we heard, and medical devices. And what does this mean for Mr. Goyal's trip? Is he going back? And can we have a timeline on when the next round of discussions will be undertaken?
We'll take it 2-3 questions at a time. Deepak ji.
मेरा सवाल ये था कि
राष्ट्रपति
जी ने बात करते हुए ये कहा कि इमरान खान और प्रधानमंत्री जी दोनों मामलों को हैंडल कर सकते हैं. क्या उनका इंडिकेशन था कि भारत और पाकिस्तान को बातचीत की टेबल पे आ जाना चाहिए?
वन मोर क्वेश्चन बिफोर वी मूव टू द नेक्स्ट राउंड.
जी This is Siddharth from the Times of India. I just wanted to understand what is our expectation from the US in terms of, you know, what we want on the trade front. Do we want restoration of GSP? Do we want doing away with of some of the higher tariffs on aluminium and steel products?